All right, we're giving a call to Mr. Milan. Hey, Milan, how you doing, man?
Hey, are we live?
We are live and ready to go.
Okay, I'm doing fine, dude. Pretty good after those hard games.
Oh man. Okay, so you took the words right out of my mouth. Hard games. At what point in the last
I
game?
don't know. I don't like playing against Hellraisers. Like, we played four games against them in 7 days. Three of them were like 70 plus minutes or something. Like, I love those games. They're good for viewers. They're fun to watch. They're super fun to watch, but it's hard for players. Like, you sweat or like all those things. It's like, especially since I'm captain from now on, it's hard to make calls, really hard. Everything matters. One bet and it's all over.
All right, so do you remember many details from the last game? Because I know there was one point where you caught Ember Spirit in the trees, you brought him down, and that was the point where you TP'd and you got the rapier from him. Just give me a feeling for what was going on through your teams. I imagine TeamSpeak or whatever you were chatting on. What was the air of the nature there? Were you like gung-ho ready to go, or was it more calm, collected?
No, we are always calm when game is going on, but if we are killing important heroes, especially like somebody with Reaper, you guys just get hyped a bit. I do at least, like Excalibur does, mostly two of us. We get hyped. We just scream. If we win a fight, after fight, we like scream a bit stuff, but not so much. We need to remain calm, like because game is not over, you know. But it's really, it was, it feeling is really good. You want to know that?
All right, I was just I'm doing the giveaway on side by side. So, the second one is actually Kip Van Der Zee. So, he is the winner of the second giveaway. Going back to that though, I mean, it's interesting to hear. Most of the time when you see things like that, you definitely see a lot of energy coming out, but sounds like you guys had a pretty level head about it. I got to give a lot of respect. Coming out of the first game, you guys won in about 30, 36 or so minutes, I think it was. Did you definitely feel like you had a much easier time in that game than the second game, or were they both kind of even? The second game just came down a little bit more to split pushing.
Yeah, but it's like maybe you couldn't see it, but first game was like at least even hard, like the second one, because first game we lost laning stage pretty hard. They pulled out Broodmother mid. We were losing all three lanes. I think we pretty much were losing all three lanes. Like we kept our calm, you know, and we're like, it's okay, we're losing all three lanes, but we can still win. But it was like it was so hard to get back out of all three lanes lost. It's same as getting out of that split push out of Ember Spirit, you know, and like bear antagonist, like worst thing to play against, like.
Oh yeah, I mean, once he got it, after he just after he got that axe, he took your middle racks. Was there any sort of demoralization that came there, where you're like, yeah, maybe we can't do this, or did you constantly have that hope that you were gonna take it all the way?
We always knew. I mean, we always expected to take the game for us, but like. We, you know, he's pushing the Rex. We have a glyph. We're calling. We don't go a glyph because Rex doesn't matter. Pretty sure if we even have a, even if they had a Mega Creeps, we could still like win a fight and go to the mid and like win a game because we had a Rapier. We had two heroes six slotted with a Beast having Refresher and stuff. So we pretty. I don't know. I didn't check the replay yet, but I'm pretty sure we led in gold for a big measure because like Gyro had
Gold
like 20k
actually was
gold.
all over the place that game. I don't think anyone had a major lead. It looked like it was more kind of even below probably about 5,000. Then it kind of spiked up and down constantly. And the one thing that you guys constantly had advantage in was experience, actually, where you were ahead in that regard. Did you feel that at all? Did you know that you guys were ahead in experience, or did you think that was a little more even?
I felt it because I was really high level on Sheikah. I had like one death and like I had a lot of moving items. You know, I had a blink, four staff, even Shadow Blade later. Like, so I could move freely, get XP wherever, get some solo pick off. And their heroes, like, their only Lina could death as well. But Shadow Demon was like stacked at one place, couldn't really do much, didn't have any items. So I felt that. Like, we were leading, so. Of course, when you have more kills, you get more XP.
Right, and you guys were definitely leading in the kills there. So, I kind of want to get an idea again. I'm trying to get a feel for what was going on and as sort of a team dynamic. After about 20 minutes in that game, you guys were finding pickoffs across the map, but never really were able to push at all. Was that sort of a decision that you guys wanted to go for the pickoffs more, or did that just kind of happen naturally where you couldn't go any further than just getting kills?
Pretty much you couldn't go. Whenever we, if we, at any point, we would go 5-man one lane, they would just go to other lane, Alacrity Bear push faster than us. They can just red us out. You just need to be patient, get a pickoffs, you get a gold XP from that, and then at some point, you just be enough ahead, push out lanes at the good moment, and then you just go push. You need to be patient against red. Can't really like go, whoa, if we don't go now, we lost. That's not how it works.
So one of the things I noticed in that last game that I kind of want to get a feel for, you went for the Manta style on a Razor instead of something like, say, a Sanjinasha completed out. What was the reasoning for the Manta style pickup as opposed to other possible items to be built?
I don't really know what was in Excalibur head, but I think he thought like you. It's really good. Like you send out Manta to lanes. You can even drag creeps. Yep. You can do those things. You can get out of chains of Ember with Manta, so you don't need to BKB. Like a lot of reasons. You can get that out of Orchid. Like I think it was perfect pickup for him.
All right. And on the same note, their Ember Spirit at one point had picked up a BKB. I didn't see them get much use out of it. Did you guys feel like that BKB was a problem for you, or was it just kind of a non-issue?
I think it was right pickoff because he couldn't get CC'd by me on Shaker. So he was like, in fights, if he pops it, he doesn't die to right clicks. And he had like Lincoln on the Invoker. So he pretty much can't get CC'd for 10 seconds. He can do whatever. So it was pretty good. But later, like, BKB helps you only in that way. If you initiate, pop BKB, 10 seconds, do whatever you want. But if somebody initiates on you, like Shaker, you don't get to pop BKB. Just like in that way, it's like works both ways. But it was fine this game for him.
Yeah, sure. And you went the Shadowblade that game, which I feel in more ways than one actually probably won you the game. A lot of the times you were able to initiate on them without knowing. Did you know that was kind of going to be the thing when you picked it up, or was it more of a I need a way to escape sort of item?
No, I thought like we took two games of them. Like we were devoiding everything. And, like that's easy. Like you can't, if you have a Shadow Blade, it's so easier to catch people. Even if they have a ward, they need to be scared of you. They need to buy sentries or games. It works in multiple ways and helps really out. And it's a really good pickup from Shaker. I could, like, if I see they don't have detection, like I could go in, kill a guy and get out. And that would frustrate them so much. And it works in that way as well. So it was a pretty decent pickup.
It was a fantastic game, dude. How are you feeling right now? You just 2-0'd HR and a 71-minute game closer. You got to tell me how that feels.
It feels pretty good. I'm not going to lie. We changed players. We changed one more player after the winter reshuffle. We split it really late with the Greek guys. So we needed to find two players really fast. We didn't have many options. So it feels good to show that we are, if not the same, even better team, I'm pretty sure. Like with new players. Those players who left were very good, very good friends of me. But those new guys are so fresh blood. Like those what fresh blood links to. Like I would say Nathan and Zeroji are really talented players, can really work out. It's like the most important thing that we all want to improve, all have the same goal. So it's very easy and enjoyable to work with those guys, all of them.
All right, and one final question. You guys are playing in the Shanghai qualifiers, correct?
Yeah, we're going to play open qualifiers since we changed a player after the lock.
Ah, so how do you feel about that? Do you feel confident? Do you feel like you're going to make it past the opens?
No, I'm going to say it, and I would suggest everyone to not, because I would like to get in the regionals as I did last time through the open qualifier, but... like I would not sacrifice my chance to get to the main to the Shanghai for like getting invited to the regionals and then losing. For I'm gonna change a player if it doesn't seems right. I already won one open qualifier for the major, so feels confident again. It's really hard task, but You know,
Oh yeah,
it's
I mean
worth of it.
it's like one game elimination, right? Or something like that.
Yeah,
Yeah,
but
so anything can happen in games like that, but I definitely feel like you guys, after that showing, you have a lot of talent behind you. You've got a lot of skill. I think you can do it. I'm very confident you can do it.
yeah, I'm as well. I'm not gonna lie.
All right, best of luck to you there, Milan. Thank you so much for coming and chatting with me after the interview. You should go back and celebrate that victory with your win. I'm going to go back and celebrate some holidays with my family. So, once again, man, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations and best of luck in Shanghai.
Thank you, mate. Happy holidays and
To you as
see you
well.
around.
See ya.
Bye.
All right, guys, that's it for our eggnog and Santa stream. Thank you so much.